The stakes have never been higher for education in terms of the impact on the prosperity of nations and communities. That's largely because of the pace of change and the world that we live in, the dynamism and the advent of technology. The ability to take a group of people and educate them so that they can be successful in that environment, for instance, learning coding skills, learning engineering, learning to be valuable in this new technology-driven world that we're going into, that in a lot of ways is going to determine the economic path of countries.
The sources of inequality comes from the inequality of skills. And the fact that some countries have been so effective in reducing inequality in skills, and that gives me hope that actually we can leverage this. Now, the 10% of the most disadvantaged school children in Shanghai, and they come from, you know, families that work as construction workers day and night, that can't spend time with their children, they don't have proper housing. Those 10% of kids now outperform the 10% of the wealthiest kids in the United States. And that shows us actually, you know, where we could be doing. We could be equipping every child with the skills to be successful.
Education gives people a sense of the world and their role in it. And so we must continue to translate the importance of education to bringing people from poverty, to making sure that access to education is about access to excellent education, not just access to a classroom.
After years and years of talk about change, what's actually happening right now is, using the power of the internet, universities all over the world are truly allowing access in a way that you typically just don't see. So for the first time in human history, you don't have to pick up your life, quit your job, and move to attend a top university while still getting the same powerful experience. That's pretty unique.
Technology, I don't think, is going to get rid of teachers. I think we still need that personal contact and support for students. But it can be used as a tool, but it really changes the function of a teacher. And could change it in a very good way. Instead of the person who kind of delivers instruction, it's more like an orchestra leader with all kinds of tools and supports and ways to individualize and provide students with learning opportunities.
I think the number one thing holding business back today is not being able to find the people with the relevant skills. Like, that is probably the biggest barrier to global progress that exists in the world right now. It's really one of the most important problems of the world. And so by solving this problem and figuring out how to bring online training of relevant skills into kind of the mainstream, you know, daily life and opportunity that exists, it will push progress forward.
I think today we have a much more equal debate, which is less around blaming different factions for the state of education and really looking to see how we can enable teachers and technologists, private sector and public policymakers to come together to solve some of those issues.